and create a new DNA or RNA file directly from the Getting Started screen, either from the File menu or by selecting New and choosing your desired file type. For example, select to create a new DNA file, then just type in or paste your sequence into the text field, and indicate whether it is linear or circular. SnapGene will automatically detect common features and show a preview of the file. Click Create to create the new file and open the full SnapGene interface. To save your file, click Save, and give the file a name. You can open existing files from the launch window, or by clicking the plus button at the top of the screen. If you have a folder containing multiple sequences, you can also open that project folder. Files contained within the folder will be listed in the project sidebar. Select a file to preview it, or double-click to open in a new tab. Once open, each file will be shown in a separate window. You can quickly switch between files by selecting the different tabs. You can open many common file types directly in SnapGene. The import option allows direct access to many online resources. You can select plasmids from the SnapGene online database, choosing from over 2,700 annotated sequences, including all common plasmid cloning vectors. Save them for later or open them directly into SnapGene. You can also do these tasks from the main SnapGene interface by selecting File. This includes importing AdGene plasmid sequences or any published sequence from NCBI, UniProt, or Ensemble using the appropriate accession number. And you're done. Watch the rest of these videos in this Getting Started series at snapgene.com.